Greetings and welcome back to the Q&A. Before I begin to answer the questions, I would like to aim two heartfelt thank yous to, first and foremost, the artisan of this absolutely epic treasure right here from Canada. With love, thank you very much yet again. Much appreciated. Goes straight into my shrine. Then from Hong Kong, with love, I have a absolutely beautiful Victorinox Swiss Army Knife. So, thank you very much, lads, for those gifts. Highly appreciated. And then also, as always, massive thank you to all of my Patreons for your continued support. Now, let's get into the first question at hand. That is from Ocean Lindgren. O glorious God Emperor of Soulkind, outside your own personally designed programs, which training programs do you endorse for your Astartes? Well, for my glorious Astartes, I recommend, I've said this before, I'll say it again, Smolov Jr. for the bench press, and then Russian squat routine for the squats. Now, these are 3 and 4 weeks, respectively, and they are to be done a few times a year. You can't do them after each other all the time, because then you will wear out your body quite quickly, and I don't mean wear out your muscles, but you will wear out your ligament, skeleton, everything like that, because it is a high intensity, a lot of pressure when you do these sort of things. So definitely check those out. There are apps for your cell phone as well, which you can use quite handy indeed. So check that out. And then for everything else, you can just go with something like 3 sets of 12 on the bodybuilding exercises. That's usually what I do myself, and I recommend that also. And then for all the other exercises, the main the heavier exercises, you can just go with 5x5. So that is what I would recommend to just give a brief introduction to someone into strength training. But then again, like Smolov Jr. and Russian squat routine, do this with a few months apart, and then when you feel strong, you feel ready in the body, then you can just give everything you have into those two smaller programs, because they are supposed to be, you know, leading up to a powerlifting meet or something like that. So do them every once in a while, but definitely do check them out so you have a good grasp of what to do in the temple. And also, I might add that one of the mistakes I see a lot of guys, they go into the gym without a set plan, and that is not good at all, because then you will of course stall if you just think you train hard but you don't know that you train hard. Knowing that you train hard is when you know that you also progress. So I hope that responded to your question. Next question from my man Liam. With the Swedish election not going as planned, what are the immediate ramifications of the election? Are you looking at some serious consequences in the coming months? Also, congratulations on the engagement. Very happy for you, brother. Ah, thank you very much. Yes, I am happy as well, and I will not dedicate this video to talking about how great my fiance is, but all father be praised. What an absolute demigoddess of a woman. So yeah, everyone can be happy for me. Now, in regards to the question at hand, nothing really. All the parties are still in negotiations, so it's too early to say anything, but the powers to be are still reigning, and the parties that represent said powers to be, they're still in charge. So yes, the political spectrum has shifted a bit, the metapolitical landscape has shifted also, but it isn't a huge difference. So, and then also the immediate ramifications, I think the establishment, at least in Sweden, they're feeling a bit confident after all, not like the American establishment felt after Donald Trump or the British establishment after Brexit. But to conclude the answer to the question, it's too early to say anything at this particular moment in time. I will probably make a video in a few months when the new parliament is being set up, and because they're doing some shadow boxing with each other to mark points, etc. So yeah, I will keep you updated when the political situation is a bit clearer. Dear Golden One, how do you recommend for people to take care of their mental well-being? Well, this is obviously a very large question indeed, but what I can say is that focus on positive things. If you constantly just look for news, look for outrage news, yeah, you will become a bit blackpilled. So look at the beauty of the world as well, especially if you're into the more political side of things. You see, oh, France is going down the drain, Sweden is in chaos, Britain is terrorizing its own citizens, and America is so degenerate. Like, if you look at all these things all the time, it's of course easy to become sad, and it's not good for your mental well-being to constantly bombard yourself with these sort of things. So my advice is scale down on some of the news every once in a while, because it's not good for you, it's not good for a... for the soul of a person to just get bombarded with bad news all the time. So the first step is that, and then also training is the, I would say, most important step. If you don't take care of your body, your mind will not feel well either. So that is two steps. Obviously, massive question, I could talk a lot more about it, but these are the two steps at least. So first and foremost, feed your mind with some positive news, with some beauty, with some good things, when things go well. That's the first step that you can just do, and then also second step, but the more important step is train hard. And if you don't train, immediately start training. If you don't have access to a gym, just run or something, and that is good for your mental well-being because of the hormones that are being unleashed when you are training hard. So I hope that responds to that question somewhat, at least. From Brian, first and foremost, looking juicy at your back picture, Brian. In a hypothetical situation, a dude has a girlfriend who has gone to university across the country. Would it be unwise for this dude to transfer to her university, as the dude's current university do not offer her program? Ooh, a very hard question to answer without knowing what is up in regards to all other things. I can't really answer, I don't want to answer, because then I might give some bad guidance because I don't know enough about it. But I'm just gonna give some general guidelines, and that is, as a man, always put your mission before women until you get a wife and children, of course, because then they will become the top priority. But until then, put your mission first at all time, and then have women as a side pursuit, as it were, because if you chase the women and have her as the top priority, she might lose respect for you. So if there is something you really want, if you feel comfortable at your current university and you're really passionate about what you are studying, I would probably stay at your current university, or the guy in the hypothetical scenario to stay at his current university. But then again, if you can just as well transfer to another place and get to know a new city, a new network, etc., you can do that as well. So anyway, to conclude, I don't want to answer because I don't know enough about the situation, but I would say that the top priority is to keep your own quest, your own mission at the top priority until you have a wife and children. But until then, it's different. So hopefully that was some guidance at least. Golden one, as I said in a previous comment thread, a friend of mine recently started to shred the shroud of degeneracy after a few bad days and one hell of a wake-up call. He has asked me to help him out of the gutter, and I was planning on showing him some of your videos, but wasn't sure which one to start with. Which ones are the best that you think I should show him to really get him into gear? It depends. I would probably explain to him the purpose of my training videos and then just watch them, and then hopefully he will get into the mood of training, because I think they are probably some of my best videos. Even though I don't talk in them, I can at least show that, you know, this is fun and this is cool, etc., to train hard. And once you get into training, it the motivation just comes to yourself, because first and foremost you will get the positive hormones from hard training, and then you will get addicted, so to speak, to training hard. There are obviously good wisdom videos I've made as well. You can look at the most watched ones. They are also, I'd say, the best ones to a large extent. But other than that, Gains Kitchen, if you want some advice on meals, and also the training videos to get that training motivation. But then, as I usually say, watch all of my videos. That's the best thing, because there are gems in many of them. And also thank you for the kind words and best wishes to your mate. And then the last question. Greetings, Golden One. In which ways, both as an individual and alongside other valiant men and women, does one best take an active part against the evil, wickedness and degeneracy that plagues our lands and the peoples of modern Europe? Thank you for your glorious work. So, very broad question, but the easy answer is to enlighten other people about certain things. So if there is a Hollywood film you think promote bad morals, for example, or you know that the porn industry is bad for everyone involved. Yeah, enlighten people about this, talk with people. That is the absolute first step to any change, no matter what kind of change you want to see. So talk with people, talk at your workplace, say like, you know what, I heard that porn decreases the willpower in your brain. You can say something like that, or you can say, I don't like this film because it promotes sexual promiscuity or whatever, or you don't like this because it promotes or glorifies drug use. So talk with people. That is the absolute first step in creating any change. So thank you for your questions and thank you for your continued support. XOXO, boom.